So this is where the eggs were found, under a nice toasty heater here, carefully excavated from around 30 centimeters underground, and almost like an archaeological dig. So mum and dad here, blissfully unaware that she has four beautiful babies. Good morning, here we are in our pump room. It's a very unglamorous title for actually quite an important space. And it just so happens that something rather special happened in this room just a few days back. We have a couple of incubators here in which we have eggs from reptiles. Probably one of the most special of those egg clutches is from Galápagos tortoises. Our two females, Snapper and Chippy, do produce eggs, and they're all excavated. They're all treated as though they could potentially hatch in 3 to 6 months. They all go in our incubators and diligently we check every single day. A very, very lucky keeper in a morning sort of haze looked in an incubator first thing. He couldn't quite believe it himself. There were four baby tortoises just peeking out of their eggs. An incredible event for us. For zookeepers, something like that is a huge confirmation that you're doing the right thing. And just to couch how important it is, just in Australasia, there are only 16 Galapagos tortoises. Four baby tortoises is quite a significant jump. In a very special part of this room, in a very dull looking grey box, is something called an incubator, which is doubling up as essentially a nest site for our baby Galapagos tortoises. So we have two boxes in here. The lower box is where they hatched, where there's some nice deep substrate. We know that a good temperature to incubate Galapagos tortoises is about 30 degrees, and the space needs to be dark. These tortoises hatched about 4 days ago. So today we're going to make some checks, making sure that their development, which continues to some extent after they hatch, is going according to plan. So here we are, three of our four, almost exact replicas of their mum and dad. It is incredible to think that these guys are due to get 3,000 times larger. Right, well, we're looking for that, of course, that they are alive, that they are active, they are reactive to the light. We're also looking crucially at the plastron, which is the underside of the animal here. You can see this seal and what's left of the fast disappearing umbilicus. It's like, you'll all know that as your belly button. We need to know that that is sealed and uninfected. So why in this fairly unglamorous cake box? Well, actually it's ideal for purpose. It's also a nice clean space, and it allows us to keep close control of their immediate environment. So we're very concerned at this stage with things like humidity and temperature. They're pretty much left alone for the duration of the incubation, with some checks along the way. As far as the tortoises are concerned, they're still in the hole in which they were dug in, and it can take between 5 and 10 days before they choose to emerge. During the night, of course, they're rustling these up and hiding underneath them. As the umbilicus we keep talking about heals up, we just don't want any debris or dirt to get caught or work their way into their bodies. So this is really just for the first sort of week, week and a half. Something like 2.5 years ago, there was huge celebration when little Pinter, the first Galapagos tortoise baby to be born at Auckland Zoo, happened. Pinter unfortunately didn't survive. She was a little bit premature. It's very, very sad for the team. The amount of effort that has gone in over the last 10 or so years into refining the husbandry of our Galapagos tortoises. And this is just such a relief to see that we have been doing the right thing, getting their diet right, getting their environment right, getting their social system correct. We're dealing with a Galapagos tortoise. Everything in their life is telescoped. So if you make a change, you might not see the benefits for months or years later. So the next stage, of course, is to set up the aquarium, if you like, where they can have slightly more naturalistic conditions. If you imagine a little tortoise like that, it's in Galapagos Islands all on its own. That is normal for these tortoises. They are equipped with everything they need to survive. We just need to do our best to provide an optimum environment for them to then go on and thrive.
My My name's Sonja. I'm one of the ectotherm keepers at Auckland Zoo. I am the species coordinator for the Galápagos tortoises. So that's really exciting at the moment. We have four juveniles that have hatched out just 2 months ago. I just have to monitor that everything's going well, not just with the juveniles, with the adults as well. Track their weights, their measurements. We're going to be doing a bit of that today, just making sure they're progressing nicely. It's just unreal to look at these tiny little miniature versions of the adults, and they could be on the earth for another 180 years. And just to know that they're going to see so much in their lifetime. But I was a little piece of it. Cool, so this is the vivarium that our four juveniles are living in at the moment. But tortoises, it's really important to have nice ventilation, so that's why it's nice and open. So caring for tortoises is actually quite a bit of science behind it. Ectotherms are really reliant on their environment, so it's up to us to create a heat gradient, a gradient of humidity. So they've all increased their body weight by at least 10 to 20%. So they're growing quite quickly on their way to be the small giants that they are. So we've put actually a little bit of twink, which is a non-toxic paint that we put on just a section of the shell here. It's just a way that we can identify each individual in the health of each individual tortoise. So this guy has his mark on the second to right scoot. So he is, I can see by his ID card, he is currently, his name is C137. We're gonna measure our tortoises, the length, the height and the width of their shell, and we're gonna weigh them. So these guys have definitely grown, and this little guy has grown at about 5 millimeters in length. Doesn't sound like much for these little guys, it's quite a lot. So he can go back. We do this every month now, and we weigh them weekly. You'll see he's tucked his little head in, so they are still quite shy, but what I'm doing here is not hurting the little guy at all, and it's really important for the husbandry that we keep track of how they're growing, so that if we see anything of concern, we can get the vets involved straight away and make sure that these guys get the best care. So we're just going to collect a little bit of dandelion and puha and plantain. These are some of the weeds that we give our baby tortoises. But as they are quite young and quite similar to kids, we have to kind of persuade them to eat the food that they don't necessarily want to. And the main part of their diet is hay. So we just make it a bit more appetizing. So I'll just grab a couple. I just want to have a little bit of colour in amongst the hay to get their attention, stimulate their appetite. So the hay itself, it's really high in fibre, low in protein, and definitely no sugars in there. I'm just going to put a little bit of a calcium plus supplement. So it has predominantly calcium carbonate, so it's really important for reptiles to have lots of calcium in their diet. So I've just made a bath for these guys in tepid water. We do this twice a week for an hour, and this is just an opportunity for them to hydrate. It also helps them to defecate or poo. It helps things loosen up a little bit. We'll see what's inside their poo, confirm that they're eating their hay. So everything we're learning as these guys are growing is really important for us, but it's also really important for the species as a whole. So we're able to share this information and allow the husbandry for this species as an endangered species to progress and advance, and therefore have a positive effect on not just these tortoises, but tortoises everywhere around the world.
I'm excited to see your designs and excited to bring the baby tortoises down. And what we're about to deliver for the baby tortoises is a kind of a bringing together of all that science.
I'm just putting the final touches in today, and it creates a thermal camera that shows us exactly where all the cold spots are, where all the really hot spots are.
You join us on a momentous day. We're about to move our baby Galápagos tortoises